Grace and peace be with you this day. In the name of a God who calls us into community together and who inhabits heaven, earth, and everywhere in between, welcome to this moment of worship with the American International Church. We are continuing to worship online only for the month of July, and as we discern the next steps ahead, we will continue to offer at least some form of online worship in the months to come. So know that wherever you're tuning in from, at whatever time you're tuning in at, we are grateful for your presence with us. In that spirit, hear this call. God who goes beside us, we are walking into unknown lands, and we cannot see what lies on the path ahead. So we come to you in prayer and worship today. Give us your perfect rest in the midst of our journey, and meet us in this place, wherever we find ourselves. We are searching for you throughout our days. Remind us that you are already here, and teach us to keep walking by your Spirit and in the way of life. Amen.
And now would you join me in praying our invocation today? The words will be on the screen for you to follow along and pray with me. Let's pray. O Lord, gather us together in your Spirit today, that we may worship you in unity and truth. Surround us in front and in back, above and below, to our right and left, and within our very souls. Place your hand upon us and whisper your words into our hearts. In your presence today, may our worship build your kingdom and bring you glory. Amen. As you hear this musical piece from Jono, we invite you to pass the peace of Christ, even though we are not together in person. Pass the peace to those in the room with you, and pass the peace of Christ to those who are not nearby, but near to your hearts with a text message or an email.
Thank you. Good morning. Our scripture today is from Genesis. Jacob left Beersheba and set out for Haran. When he reached a certain place, he stopped for the night because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones there, he put it under his head and lay down to sleep. He had a dream in which he saw a stairway resting on the earth, with its top reaching to heaven, and the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. There above it stood the Lord, and he said, I am the Lord, the God of your father Abraham and the God of Isaac. I will give you and your descendants the land on which you are lying. Your descendants will be like the dust of the earth, and you will spread out to the west and to the east, to the north and to the south. All peoples on earth will be blessed through you and your offspring. I am with you and will watch over you wherever you go, and I will bring you back to this land. I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. When Jacob awoke from his sleep, he thought, surely the Lord is in this place, and I was not aware of it. He was afraid and said, how awesome is this place? This is none other than the house of God. This is the gate of heaven. Early the next morning, Jacob took the stone he had placed under his head and set it up as a pillar and poured oil on top of it. He called that place Bethel, though the city used to be called Luz. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Instead of my typical opening centering prayer at the start of the sermon, I'd like to sing us into the Spirit and sing myself this morning. So will you join with me in prayer? Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel his mighty power and his grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Amen. These words come from today's story in Genesis, from Jacob's dream and the realization that God was with him. And for me, this particular song, even the phrase, surely the presence of the Lord is in this place, take me to certain places, to the places in my life where I have felt the presence of God. I think about a particular stretch of beach in my hometown where I always go to sit and to pray and listen to the sound of the waves. I think about the Blue Ridge Mountains, also back in my home state, which have whispered to me of God since I was a little girl visiting my grandparents. More than anything, of course, I think about church, sitting alone in an empty sanctuary to pray. Sitting in our sanctuary, sitting in any sanctuary. And even more, of course, when we're all in it together, singing, hugging, passing the peace, sharing bread and wine at the altar and cookies and cakes in the back with kids crawling under the pews. That line in the song that says, I see glory on each face. When I look out over all of you in worship, I really do see God's glory. When I seek the presence of the Lord, those are the places I go. I'm guessing you have places too, and probably church is one of them. Of course, we're all cut off from many of those places right now. There will be no trip to my home state, my hometown, no visits from family or friends, and it's not yet safe to gather in person for church. And even if we did, most of my favorite bits, singing, shaking hands, sharing food, kids running loose, even seeing all of your faces, none of those things would be allowed right now. Because I love you all so much, I don't hesitate to stay apart, to keep everyone safe, to wear a mask, to make sure that we can all stay well and we can regather and do all those things again someday. But it's hard to be cut off. Cut off from you, cut off from the places that we go to find God. In this story in Genesis, Jacob is cut off too. No pandemic here. It's all his own fault. He tricked his brother Esau out of his birthright and his blessing, and Jacob had to run off into the desert, eventually to his uncle's house. But for this story, he's out in the middle of nowhere, sleeping on the ground with a stone for a pillow. Alone, under the stars, he has a strange dream. He sees a ladder to heaven with angels going up and down between this world and that one. And then God's own self appears to him and blesses him. Jacob is startled and says, "Oh, God, it's you. I didn't know you were there." It reminds me of the behavior of young children in the middle of the night sometimes. I think every parent I know has had this experience, and probably many of you with younger siblings or who've stayed over in the house with nieces or nephews, you might have experienced the same. You're lying in bed, mostly asleep, and you open your eyes because you see out of the corner a ghostly figure standing next to your bed, just standing there, silent, staring at you. It's terrifying. It's the child, of course, but as you emerge from your dream, all you see is a shadow hovering next to your face, watching you sleep. "Ah, what are you doing? Why are you here? Why are you standing in the dark staring at me?" I feel a bit like God sneaks up on Jacob in his dream in the same way. "What are you doing, God? Why are you here? This isn't where I expected to see you. Not here, not in the middle of the night. The presence of the Lord is here, and I didn't know it." Jacob discovers he's not so cut off after all. Turns out God dwells in this place in the middle of nowhere. So he sets up his pillow rock as an altar to remind him of God's presence. And he names that altar Beth-El, House of God, so that he and everyone else might know that God resides here. Barbara Brown Taylor makes this story the cornerstone of her book, An Altar in the World. Jacob's dream, she says, teaches us that God can drop a ladder almost anywhere. We're free to see the whole world as an altar where the divine could erupt. The reason we build churches is not to house God, to shelter from the world, but as a reminder that the whole world is God's house. She writes, "Earth is so thick with divine possibility that it is a wonder we can walk anywhere without cracking our shins on altars." I have seen that very thing in our last 4 months apart. I've seen God drop a ladder into a Zoom meeting and known the divine to erupt through a call or a text that arrives just when it's needed. More than once, I've been out for a walk and chanced upon a familiar face and stopped for a chat and felt the Spirit's presence so strongly in that meeting that I wanted to build an altar right there on the pavement in London. Here in my dining room, on my dining room table, I have built right behind the camera an altar of books to hold my smartphone while I film all of my sermons and recordings. And after 17 weeks, It feels like this book altar is endowed with something of holiness. It's a ladder that seems to bridge the gap between you and me and God. The internet, like those angels going back and forth all the time, so that we are not cut off from one another. But it's not just my house. It's your house too. Wherever you are watching this on YouTube, somewhere or nowhere, God is with you, gathering to hold you and to receive your worship. Every time you zoom in to a church event on my screen, I see glory on each face. And your house becomes the house of God. We see you living out your faith in your tidy kitchen or your messy bedroom, on your cozy sofa, or in your lovely black back garden. We see God watching over you in your house. And it reminds those of us on the other end that God's watching us in our houses too. Between your messages and your offerings, your vulnerability, your faith, your struggle, your hope over the last 4 months, I have been cracking my shins on altars all around. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place, in your place, and we did not know it. My friends, we are out here in nowhere a little while longer. But this is the house of God. And everywhere, all around us, are ladders full of angels going up and down, from you to me to God, from earth to heaven. God is blessing us in every place we are. The presence of the Lord is with you. I see it. Amen.
The Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified and died. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. Judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Now is the time where we remember God's presence in our midst and we lift our concerns to God in prayer. When we pray together over Zoom and when you join us in prayer wherever you are, we believe that God joins us as well and we are united and connected to one another. If you want us to pray over particular concerns, please let us know at prayer@amchurch.co.uk so that your ministry team can be praying for you throughout the week. Let us go together now in prayer. God of our spiritual mothers and fathers, and of countless generations before us, we praise you today. We come to your presence with gratitude for your everlasting faithfulness to your people. Thank you for the blessings you've given us and for your generosity and grace. And we rest in hope because your promises are eternal and guaranteed by the honor of your holy name. Thank you for the confidence of your goodness and love that carries us through.
Mold us and shape us in your image as one part of your global church. Give our eyes your sight today so that in the eyes of those around us, we will see your children. Give our ears your attentive spirit so that we may hear your voice and join the divine tune of your goodness in the world. Give our hands your gentle touch to reach out with love to the hurting and grieving. Give our lips your words to speak love and justice where hatred and death seem too strong. Give our feet the strength to keep walking in your ways, carrying your good news everywhere we go.
We join our hearts together in praying for your healing in life where we seem to only sense brokenness and pain. And so we lift up our neighbors and families to you. Heal the ill and ease the suffering of body and mind. Give peace to the dying and comfort to those who mourn. Free the afflicted and oppressed. Soothe the anxious and depressed. Lift up the downtrodden and bless the impoverished. Save the lost. And we pray for all whose work is healing, caring, and providing for others. Give wisdom to our leaders, protect our healthcare workers and key workers, give rest to caregivers.
Thank you for your faithful presence among us, even when we are not fully aware of it, even in the most unexpected and lonely places. Continue to reveal yourself to us, O Lord. Open our eyes to see you here among us. Open our ears to hear your words, for surely you are with us in this place. And with hearts emboldened because you are here with us, we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Welcome once again to worship, and thank you for joining us as we continue to worship online as a way of protecting the vulnerable among us and showing our love to our communities. We are praying with you and worshiping with you throughout the week, and we invite you to join us as well on our YouTube channel and on our Facebook page. You will find moments to pause for prayer and a weekly children's message via YouTube. We also have some new times to connect with other people through our book study of Akala's book, Natives, and through our Crosstown Connections. Both of those have already begun, but it's not too late to join in either of those. If you are interested in joining a Crosstown conversation with people who share some of your interests, please contact me and I can get you connected with a group. And if you would like to join our book study, see the details in the weekly email, but it will not be a problem for you to join the book study in the second week, beginning on Monday. And we owe you in these times a debt of gratitude for the way that our congregation has continued to give to our church's ministry. And we invite you to continue ministering with us by giving. Details for how you can arrange an online payment, even though there is no offering plate, is in the description of the YouTube video below. And now let's continue to worship through singing.
Morning breath.
Surely the presence of the Lord has been with us in this place, and that presence remains with you in your place. As you stay at home, as you journey out and about, may you crack your shins on the altars in testimony to God's presence all around us. And as you go, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you now and always. Amen.